Heard some grinding up in the right front when applying the brakes on this 1998 Chrysler Town & Country. And so it looks like the pads are gone. Back ones are gone too. I didn't really hear any squeal from this telltale. It's been scratching right there. This is a little rough. I think probably some metal is exposed in there. So we'll see how that turns out once I have the caliper off. I switched ends to the boxed end and that loosened it. Don't push the fluid back up into the anti-lock brake system. You get contamination up there and mess it up. So let it bleed out here. Let's see if I can do this one-handed. That clamp may drop off, but we'll see. Okay, you can see a little bit of fluid dripping out there. You compress the piston back into the caliper. You can do this either before or after you loosen the caliper. I've compressed the piston most of the way. I'm going to take the caliper loose. Well, first I'm going to close the bleed valve. Okay, then 10 millimeter bolts here. I'll use a ratchet handle for those, and then we'll show what comes up after that. There are two 10 millimeter headed bolts, one for the bottom, one for the top, and then the caliper slides out like that. Pretty easy. Okay, here's one pad. You can see why it was making a scratchy sound. And the piston could be compressed a little bit more, so I'll put that C-clamp up there, open the bleed or valve again, and squeeze that on in. All right, here's the C-clamp in position to continue pressing the piston in. Won't take much more, and then I'll take that pad off. Okay, I've pressed it in almost all the way. I think it's in far enough for new pads. Here's the old one from here. I'll have to one-handed and left-handed. Pretty easy job. I'm going to let that rest up there. Okay, I need to look at the hose, see if there are any cracks. I have the caliper suspended by a clothes hanger. The disc is 11 inches in diameter. Many people would just automatically buy new rotors or discs. Others would take them to the parts place and have them turned down to a smooth surface. I've decided I'm going to use a drill motor and a sanding disc to just buff up the surface a little bit. There have been times when I put pads on a rotor just like that and had fine results. When you're putting the caliper back on the bracket down here, realize that this little sliding part can move, and it has to be pushed out of the way so it can fit over these little tabs where the bolts thread in. So in the process of sliding it on, just work those until they're in place. I've used a sanding disc to buff up those surfaces or rough them up a little bit before, and it worked okay. As I said, I've also just left them the way they are, and that seemed to work okay too. Put a little brake grease on the bolts because they slide as the pads wear down, and they need to be able to slide freely so that the caliper will be centered as it wear takes place. This pad goes on the inside and snaps into the piston. The outside pad snaps over like this. It's a two-handed job, so I'll have to put my camera down. Okay, I'll see if I can put the caliper back on one-handed. And videotape it at the same time. Okay, now I have to reach behind there and slide these little things out of the way to let it move on in. Now this little tab part slips up under here, and the bottom one just slides forward on that. As I said, you need to work these little things out of the way so that they can slide into place. When all of that's in place, you should be able to slide the bolt right in, and it should start threading. You may have to manipulate a little bit just to get the alignment there. I think I caught the threads. I'm going to do that with my other hand holding the caliper up. I like to verify that it will start by hand before I put any major force on it. Now I'll put the wheel back on and may have to pump up the brake a little bit, but that fit very well. So much easier than the old drum brakes. These rotors or disc brakes with the pads like that are much easier.